Hello. Happy day after yesterday. See, I told you I'd be back. So, we just finished kicking the crap out of Nutcracker. Well, okay, maybe kicking the crap out of is a little bit generous, but we survived. We have a few scars, but we're no worse for the wear. So we have to place this dragon orb on this pedestal, which looks more like a croissant orb, to be perfectly honest. And it's not just a simple matter of going through. We have to grab it and then run through before that thing crushes you. Of course, it won't actually crush you. It'll just sort of push you out of the way. But we can place your orb back if we want to get back through. Alright, well, this is very exciting. I said yesterday that there's no... that the fun was over, that it's pretty much just boss battles from here on out. That wasn't totally true. There's still a little bit more fun that I forgot about. So that's good. Of course, your definition of fun may vary. Oh, wait. That's right. The whole point is that you have to bring the orb up to that pedestal. Well, see, I'm showing you what the average person would do. The average person would have placed the dragon orb on the first pedestal, and then just gone through with that thing open and not realized that they had to bring it with them. But you do have to bring it with you. So, video games, guys. I know I've been absent for a while. I've been taking a little bit of an extended break. I kind of fell into a nearly bottomless spelunky hole there for a while, where I was playing that game like it was a part-time job. But I think I'm through that phase. I still enjoy playing it. I'll still go back to it. But
end of the line, Buttonhead. Get your sorry butt up.
No, I must have used up all of my magic. Now I'm fallen, and I can't get up! But now that the golem is ready and the black seal is destroyed, the overlord will be here very soon! Oh, I can hardly wait!
Then I'll just have to put the black seal back!
Are you deaf? I just said that the Black Seal is gone! Kaput! Destroyed! It don't work no more!
What? Back so soon? I thought you were running home to your mommies. I started thinking about how that old muttonhead tricked me. And the more I thought, the madder I got. So I talked Slick into coming back with me to finish what we started. But how did you get through the wall? You need the Dragonstone to do that. Hey, don't forget, I'm a dwarf artisan. I can craft devices out of mithril that can do amazing things.
Ouch! Why, you little...
Wait a minute, I still have one question for the big shot. Okay, Muttonhead, this is your last chance. How do I seal the Overlord again?
Oh, well, I don't know.
What? You engineered this whole mess! You must know how to seal him again!
No, there isn't any way to seal him again! He's here to stay! The only way to be done with it is to destroy him.
Okay, right, sure. All I have to do is destroy him. I mean, how hard can that be? He's just an all-seeing, all-knowing superhuman maniac hell-bent on crushing the life out of anything that moves. Sure, no problem.
Come on, Maylee. Don't wig out on us now. You're our only shot at stopping this colossal cosmic creep cake. You gotta keep it together.
Don't worry, Slick. It's just a matter of finding his weakness, and I will find it. And everyone knows that all powerful maniacs have lots of treasure. If the Overlord is defeated, it will be ours to take. You guys stay here and keep an eye on the crybaby. He's a tricky little squirt. Don't take your eyes off him for a second.
Okay, so a few things. Number one, we didn't need the dragon orb. We didn't need to kill whatever boss it was that gave us that. That glug guy could have made one for us this whole time, so that was a nice waste of time. Number two, Muttonhead completely beat into submission by Slick waving his foot a few inches from Muttonhead's face. Kind of out of character, but okay, I'll buy it. Number three, they sure seem to know a lot about the Overlord, considering the game pretty much hasn't told us anything about him, what he is, what his motivations are, what he looks like. But apparently he's an all-knowing, all-seeing, power-hungry maniac, or whatever Mail called him. And finally, number four, Colossal Cosmic Creep Cake. Pretty good. Pretty good, Slick. Oh, hey, someone made a statue that looks sort of vaguely like me with a helmet, I guess? I don't know. The shield, it looks similar, but it's hard to tell from that side angle view. Maybe that's one of Mail's predecessors. Alright, so it's going to throw some from jumping at us, so we'll switch to the guy what knows jumping best. Good old Gaul. I probably should have switched to Gaul for some of this dialogue, but I don't know. Since it is Popful Mail's game, you know, her name's in the title, and we're coming up so close to the end of the game, I thought I'd give her a little bit of time in the spotlight. Since, you know, we have used Gaul and Tap for a lot of the cutscenes. Alright, so, let's see, how many orbs do we have? We use the dragon orb, so that leaves us with red, blue, yellow, and black. So, first one looks orange, but I think that's supposed to be red. This next part is, it's pretty relaxing. There's not much fighting going on until the next boss. Switch back to Mail to move a little bit faster through this area. It gives you a little bit of a breather. It's not quite the bam, 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 boss rush that I seem to remember it being. One of Tat's ancestors, perhaps? Could be. Or maybe it's not, and I'm just making that up. Gold. What am I going to do with some gold at this point? Not much. Alright, Gaul. Oh, disappearing blocks. Let me tell you, if you're making a game where people jump, and you don't know what else to do, stick some disappearing blocks in there. We dealt with these in the Mega Man 2 Let's Play, and in the Taz and Escape from Mars LP. They were particularly annoying in Taz in Escape from Mars. They should have just called it Taz Escapes from Mars. That would have made a little more sense. I don't think there's anything else in here, so we'll just head on through the door. Alright, so that was the red orb. Now we have the blue orb. That sound effect could be a little bit more impressive. You know, there could be like the clattering of machinery or some sort of fanfare maybe. But no, it's just sort of a generic video game bleep. Alright. Two down, two to go. Is this going to be Gaul? I bet. Okay. So it's a platypus with wings that kind of look like Gauls. I guess that maybe that's what Gauls evolved from. They evolved from platypus-like creatures. Perhaps. Oh yeah, this room. This is where they just kind of gave up. They're like, here. Here's a column of disappearing blocks. I don't know. Leave me alone. That's what I would have said if I was the designer of this game. Alright. Wasn't quite sure what to do with these at first, but, see, you can just walk through them if you don't know what they're for. I tried attacking them, but no, you actually have to jump on top of it like that. Alright, so let's switch out to Gaul, and I'm pretty sure this jump is... well, maybe not. I made that jump last time, so I don't know what to tell you. Okay, well, no huge loss, I guess. I mean, we're not going to use Gaul in combat anytime soon. Okay, so red. Okay, that one's red, so I guess the first one was yellow. See, when it looks orange, it can kind of go both ways, you know? Alright. Gaul, I love you, but you're too dang slow. Alright, so, yellow, blue, red, and finally, the piece de resistance. That's just one of the guard dudes from the elf village, I guess. I don't know. I don't know who else that could be. They needed a fourth character, I guess. Could have made a guy that looks like Muttonhead. Or, you know, one of the actual characters in the game. Not just a throwaway character. Oh, maybe it's supposed to be Slick. Oh, crap. Okay, Gaul. Oh, man. Oh, that didn't work. I wonder if those blocks respawn. Well, that one did, but not the one we need. Okay. I guess it could have been one of Slick's ancestors. I mean, Slick is one of those elf guys, right? Could have been his great-uncle. His great-granduncle. Oh, man. Man, these pendulums really remind me of some game, but I can't put my finger on what they look like. Ah, crap. I'm gonna have to leave and come back, aren't I? Well, no, I might be able to make it. Yeah, okay. Now I have to leave and come back. Great. That's how it always works. You do it perfectly the first time in your practice run. But then after that, you know, when it actually matters. Oh, I forgot to close Skype, so you heard a Skype noise. Sorry about that. Hopefully someone will initiate a call. Which probably won't happen. That doesn't happen that often. Okay, so I need to move that one up, that one up, that one up, and that one to the right. Because there's no other way to get up here without using that block. No awesome jumping tricks will work there. Alright. I guess I could give Gaul some dialogue since he's not actually going to fight this guy. Oh, first things first. Save it up. Been playing this for over 6 hours now. That's just for you guys. It's been much longer for me. Okay, Gaul.
At last you've come. Even as we speak, the Overlord is awakening to claim his empire. Soon, the whole world will be ours.
Nice dream, Kazyr! This game's almost over, and I'm pressing all the right buttons! You don't stand a chance, bucko!
Oh, just the way I like it. Defiant to the end.
This game's almost over. Good job, Gaul. Okay, so for this fight, we actually want to use Tat. I know, it's crazy, right? But his weapon is the best against this guy. This boss isn't really hard, it's just very tedious. It takes a long time. And if you make a small mistake, it can, things can go south in a hurry. I want to switch my amulet, even though I probably wouldn't have gotten hit there. It didn't look like the fireballs were close enough to me. Now with Tat, since his projectile can travel, you can actually kind of combo this guy and get a few hits in on him before he switches to his firebird form, which is nice. Mail and Gaul cannot do that with their weapons. Which is why even though Tat does the least amount of damage of the three, he's still the best one for this fight. It's actually much more tedious if you try to use one of them. Uh-oh. Whew, that was close. Well, sort of. Alright, going okay so far. Oops. Damn, probably could have gotten a hit there. Oh well. So who is this guy anyway? Kazyr? I think we heard his voice at some point in the game. Oh wait, no, we saw him talking to the two ladies. Riff and Raph, in that one cutscene. That's the only time we've actually seen him, though, I think. I guess he's one of the Overlord's flunkies? I don't exactly know. Story of this game... not so great. Oh man, great combo, great combo. Keep going, keep going. Ah, crap. That was really good. We shaved a lot of time off this fight by doing that. In the fact, it doesn't mention that that Tat's the best one for this fight, which is kind of surprising. So, hot tip, if you're trying to play this game and you only have the fact on game facts, this is some information you need to know. Oops, ran out of juice right at the end. Alright, well, I feel like that went pretty well. Kazyr is destroyed. You know, you really shouldn't use the passive voice like that. It's sloppy writing.
So long have I waited for this. Oh, this liberation from the bonds of the Overlord. At last, I'm free. You may have the strength to defeat the Overlord after all. Put the final orb in its place. The Overlord is coming. The way stands before you.
I sure hope this restores the Black Seal. If it doesn't, we're dead meat.
Here we go.
Here goes nothing.
You know, I really could have done without all the gulping in that guy's death scene. I thought that was a tad much. So here we are, the final area of the game. We cannot even fast travel out of here. We are stuck here until the end. So, no more shops. No more gold. We're almost done, guys. This is really exciting. So once again, tune in tomorrow for the next installment of Popful Mail. Will it be the last installment? Could be. I don't think so, though. I think there's going to be two more, is what I'm estimating. So, yeah, see you guys then.